In this video, we're going to be talking about file version histories in Box. You can access Box by going to tufts.box.com and logging in with your Tufts username and password, which I've already done, and I've gone into this test folder here where I'm going to demonstrate what version history is. Version history is a super useful feature within Box where what happens is, as you work with files and you make edits to them and save them back to Box, Box is going to record those versions for you. So it'll store information like who updated each of those versions and when they did it. And even better than that is with the 100 most recent versions of a particular file, Box is going to back them up for you. So you have a couple of extra options for going back and downloading those versions of the file or removing them or restoring them, as we'll see later. So to begin, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just show how versions are created. Let's say, for example, I have this document that I had created and edited in the desktop version of Word. Right now, there are 6 versions of this that have been recorded to Box. As you can see here, it says V6 in this little indicator. So if I want to edit that, I can click on the More Options button and then open with Microsoft Word. And the desktop version of Word is going to open for me, where I can go ahead and I can make edits. So I can, for example, take this and I can remove the underline. Maybe I can add some color to it for emphasis, put a little smiley face. Now, once I've done all of this work, with the desktop application, I have to manually save. So I'm going to save right now. And you can see when I go back into Box, if I refresh this page, now there are 7 versions recorded. So Box has made a note for me here that I put a new version of this into my Box account. The online versions of the Microsoft Office applications are a little different. The way that they work is that they save your changes automatically for you as you go. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to take this and I'm going to select More Options, Open With, Word Online. And the online version is going to open up in a browser tab for me. And in here, I can edit my document. So I can make this bold. I can underline it. Maybe get rid of that exclamation point. But as I make all of these edits, Box keeps saving my changes for me. I don't have to manually save it. So as I do that, more and more versions are going to be recorded. And that's something to keep in mind. So I'm going to close out this browser tab. I'm going to go back into Box and I'm going to refresh this page. And as you can see now here, it says V7. But the problem is that over time, let's say I'm working with that document in the online version of Word over the course of like an hour, the more time I spend in there and the more times Office Online keeps auto-saving for me, it's really going to increase very quickly the number of versions that I have stored here. So that's something that you want to think about when you're choosing between using the desktop or the online versions of those Office applications. You can access the version history of a given file in a couple of different ways. You can right-click on a file and then go to Properties and select Version History. You could also access that by going to the More Options button here or in a file preview window. And then once that opens up, select Properties, Version History. Or if you click on the file go into the file preview by clicking on the file name, in the file preview, you'll also see in the activity window here information about versions that you have. So for example, I could click on this little icon. That will open up the version history window, or you can click on the version indicator. So where it says V7 over here, or in like a file list, for example, that tells you the number of versions that you have recorded, and when you click on that, there's the version history window. The way that this is organized is that the most current version of a file is going to be at the top, and there's a little indicator here that says current. And then the previous versions of the file are listed beneath that chronologically from most recent to least recent. As I said earlier, the 100 most recent versions of a file are going to be backed up for you, and then you have a couple of options. You can select download to download a copy of that version if you'd like. So you could save it to your desktop and then open it up and look at it. You could also make a version of your file the most current one. So what I mean by that is if I click on this, Box is going to make this version, version 6, the newest version of that file, and it's going to put it at the top. So version 6 will still be there, but then a copy of that will be made, and that will be called version 8. So I can demonstrate that. You see here now it says version 8, so I click on that, and there's that new version that I just generated. Finally, another thing that you can do if you want is you can go back and remove versions from this version history timeline. So maybe, let's say for example, this version 7 here, if for some reason I don't want that to be part of my version history, I can click on remove, and it will take that out of that timeline. Now, that is not quite permanent yet. You can still restore that version if you'd like by clicking on restore here. And in this case, if I don't do that, Box will permanently remove that version from the timeline or version history on June 30th for me. So it gives you 30 days to do that. The last thing that I want to demonstrate, so I'm going to close out this file preview window, is a feature called Upload New Version. Some time has passed and I'm back in my tests folder here, and as you can see there are now 11 versions of this document that I've been editing in the desktop version of Word. And let's say that over time, at some point, I had decided to save a copy of this to my local device. So in this case, I downloaded a version of that to my desktop over here. I'm going to go ahead and open that up. The important thing to keep in mind with local copies like this is that they are no longer linked to Box. So they're no longer covered by Box's security protections, and changes that I make in here, any edits that I make, are not going to be saved back to Box automatically. So for example, I can make this bold and I can put in a little smiley face again. And these changes, when I save them, because I'm working with my local copy, they are saved to my local copy, they're not going to be saved back to Box. So no new version is created over here. But if I've been working on this local copy and I decide that, you know what, I really want this to be the most current version of the file that I have in Box, I can do that. So I'm going to close this out. And one way that I can upload a new version of something is for that file, you can click on the More Options button and then select Upload New Version. And in the window that opens up, you select the file that you want to upload as the newest version and click on Open. As you can see here, that's being uploaded for me, and now this has changed and there are 12 versions that have been stored. So that new version has been recorded for me. And if I click on this indicator here, the version history window opens up and there is that version that I uploaded. So it is now the most current version of that file. Thank you for watching this video on version history in Box. If you'd like more information, go to the Box service page at access.tufts.edu/box.